get ready to match the stars. Mark Holden. Nolene Brown. Tommy Hamlin Jr. Abigail. Stuart Wagstaff. And Barry Creighton. As we play Graham Kennedy's Blackety Blanks. And now, here he is, here's Graham.
Monday, Tuesday, blankety blanks. Wednesday, Thursday, blankety blanks. Forget it. Hello, Mark Holden.
Good evening.
What's with you?
Not much, no. No, I've been
saw the special.
Did you?
It was terrible.
Good. Thank you.
No, it was dazzling.
Oh, yes.
And it rated well. Did you hear the ratings?
No, go on.
Nearly a 3 in Melbourne. Hello, Nolene.
Hello, darling.
How are you?
I'm very well.
What are you in at the moment, my
pet? I don't think I'm in anything at the moment.
You're not working, are you, my love? Oh, aren't you about to do something?
I'm in something secret. Yes.
She's in something secret.
Yes, a dirty movie. It isn't. It isn't.
I think I'm going to be in one.
Are you?
Not a dirty one.
Just one where you show it all.
I'm already in one of those. Don's part is doing well in... yes, it is. It's opened in Melbourne. That's I think it's over in Sydney, but it's opened in Melbourne. It's been on a couple of weeks. And
you're the best thing in it.
No, but it's doing well. It's my pleasure to have a friend from the past. And we started off together many years ago in a funny program called IMT.
Yes.
Tommy Hanlon Jr., ladies and gentlemen. Where's the circus? Tell us about the circus.
What month is it?
It's April the 6th in Melbourne and April the 20th in Sydney.
Well, it's either...
Try Perth.
It's either in Surfers Paradise or up around Townsville somewhere.
But it's going well.
Oh, not too good.
What's wrong?
Well, we had to lay off one of the Siamese twins.
What was wrong with it?
What?
What was wrong? Oh, that's the finish.
That's it. That's it, right?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Listen,
I'm not thinking well.
First time I've been on the show, I got two of them.
Yes, yes, that sometimes happens. If one dries up, then you've got another chance.
Oh, good. Yes, I was
all right?
Worried.
To lay off one of the Siamese twins. Yeah, Abigail, my darling heart, welcome to Blankety Blakes. This is the first time you've played with me.
Yes.
Ha-ha. Because that's one of the great mysteries. I'd like to know, we all want to know, Abigail what? Is it Abigail McMahon? Abigail Claghorn? But we'll never
might
know.
Might definitely be Claghorn.
It's just Abigail. How's your new single doing? Well, it's not all that new now.
No, it was released just after Christmas. It's called Biting My Nails. It's starting slowly.
Good on you. Mm. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
Stuart, we missed you.
Thank you. I was on the Gold Coast in Brisbane.
Why?
Working.
Oh.
I'd booked this before the dates were changed for recording.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Well, it's very nice to have you back.
I saw an interview with Abby made the first week she arrived in Australia, and they mentioned her surname, and damn it, I've forgotten it.
Oh, really?
In Perth, Max Bostock interview.
That's right, yes.
I'll look it up again when I'm next in Perth and find out and tell you.
Thank you. Thank you for wearing the tangerine jacket.
I've had it for a long time.
We've come to know and love that since 1941.
Can't wear the colours plain. It's the same as a supervisor.
Yes, it is. The stewards on a jumbo wear exactly that colour.
I know.
You could be a senior. Would he ever be a senior steward? And welcome, Barry Creighton.
Thank you very much.
Son of Naked Vicar.
Son of Naked Vicar, the speakeasy restaurant.
Do you get the gymnasium? Is that a deal?
Well, how about that? The City Gym, yes. I think that's a good place to go.
Because you're allowed to say that if you want to.
Great gym. If you're passing that way, pop in and have a look at the place.
Good.
Made me healthy.
Now, when we left you last, we'd got up to the supermatch situation and Lawrence Sutton was about to win $1,000. Welcome, Lawrence. Tommy had to lay off one of the Siamese twins. I don't know. Well, see, Siamese twins are... I'll tell you after. We polled a recent group of pygmies and they told some very tall stories. No, we didn't. We polled a recent studio audience and discovered their most frequent response to this. Oh. Blank it off. Now, if you give the same answer that this group of people gave most often, you receive $100. If you give the answer they second, was their second choice, you get $50, third $25 if you match it. And three of our celebrities are waiting breathlessly to give you some ideas on Blanket Off.
Stuart Wagstaff?
editing mentally, I think.
No, well, I mean, if you're thinking about that, of course, because it means a deal or something like that.
I'll say Take It Off, which is one take step it towards off. It.
Nolene Brown?
Nolene.
Knock It Off.
Oh! Knock It Off! From old Knockers Brown.
Tommy Hanlon Jr.
Tommy Hanlon Jr.
Pull It Off.
Pull It Off is a good answer. So what have we got? Take It Off, Knock It Off, Pull It Off. As in making a deal. He pulled off that deal. What, do you like any of those?
I think I'll take Stuart's answer. Take It Off.
Take It Off, you think. All right. We will find out as we ask Peter the Phantom Puller to pull off the $25 response. Thank you, Peter. Knock It Off. Pull the $50 answer. Thanks, Pete. Get It Off. Oh, sort of like Take It Off. Well, what's a... Let's hope it's... well, we'll find out. Pull the $100 answer. Thank you, Peter.
Yeah! Yeah!
Lawrence. You've won $100. Now you play for 10 times that amount. $1,000. Must match one of our celebrities precisely. Now, who do you think?
Well, I think I'll stick with Stuart.
With Stuart, all right. Right. Turn around and face me, Lawrence. Mark Blank. M-A-R-K Blank. And Stuart has written for $1,000. Mark?
One.
Mark won. Mark won. I don't think Stuart's got that.
I was thinking more in terms of a military or exercise thing, Mark Time.
Nobody Sorry. Thought of Mark Holden.
I thought of it, but I rejected it again.
Sorry. Never mind, you're still the champion, you're still in the game. We'll be back and play Blankety Blanks right after this. We met Lawrence, of course, last time. He's he holds a Kentucky Fried Chicken. Tommy, got an interest in Kentucky?
Just Kentucky.
Oh, of course, Tommy Hanlon, born in Bluegrass, Kentucky.
Yeah.
But Lawrence has a Kentucky Fried Chicken in King's Cross. Can you imagine how well that does? But we haven't met Susan Elliott, our new challenger. Hello, Susan. Your story.
Well, there's not much to tell, really.
Go on.
Well, I'm 26.
Yeah.
I've been married for 8 months.
Golly.
Yeah. And we're just in the process of buying our first home.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So you could use some money.
Right.
Let's get you some. A or B?
I think I'll take A, thank you.
It's round one. Everybody plays. Every match is worth a point. Cyril is such a super salesman. Cyril is such a super salesman. He once sold a frilly laced dress to blank. Cyril is a super salesman. I mean, he can sell stuff, Cyril Gann. He once sold a frilly laced dress to blank. Blank can be two words if you're thinking of someone. Boing, ba-doing, boing. Boing, ba-doing, boing. It's very hot tonight. It's very, very hot tonight. Put it in, Abigail, if you've written it.
I beg your pardon?
Shove it in.
Oh, I see.
That's the girl.
Oh, right.
Cyril is such a super salesman, he once sold a frilly laced dress to...
His father?
His father. Now, that would be... you would be a super salesman if you sold a frilly laced dress to your dad.
Right.
Wouldn't you?
Yes.
You haven't got that, Mark.
Have you? You're completely right, you know. I have got a man.
A man. A man and a father. What's another word for your father? A man. Oh, Tony the moustache twirler. All right.
He's tough.
I just thought in this... No? Right. Null in.
Well, I can promise you something. I haven't got his father. But there's no... You know, he could have been one of those cupboard... type collector of dresses. No, it was Norman Erskine.
Upside down.
Upside down.
Yeah, no, that's funny because we all know Norm, and
he'd
Norm in a frilly lace dress. I don't think he's. He hasn't done that since he's in the 20s. Tommy.
Yeah.
What have we got? We're looking for his father.
No.
No. Gough Whittle. That would be a super salesman to get Gough into drag, I think. Abigail, what do we have from you?
I was thinking of garden parties, the vicar.
The vicar? Would be a super salesman to do that?
I was really thinking the most unlikely person in the world to wear a dress, and I came up with Muhammad Ali.
Muhammad Ali. Yeah. Yes.
You wouldn't
yeah.
criticise that, though, would
that's,
you?
That's terrific.
Right on, maybe.
No, I'm not with it yet. I thought he might sell one to Cecil, but he wouldn't have to be such a super salesman.
Perhaps not, no. His friend Cecil. No, all right. B, for Lawrence, our champion, Barney puts weight on in unusual places. Once he put 20 pounds on his blank. This is Barney. He puts weight on in unusual places. Once he put 20 pounds on his blank. Bit of trouble down here. Why not? That would be
clean.
It's very. Mark's got a problem.
Boring. Very boring.
Is it all right?
Worst one down there.
Stuart, is it?
No, there's another funny one. Right in, my love, or else your light doesn't go on. That's it. Barney puts weight on in unusual places. He once put 20 pounds on his...
Make it clean. Behind?
Behind. Make it clean. Behind. Behind, nobody said behind for a long time. Nearly everyone says bum. They truly do in this show. It's a weird show.
Yes, my mother said that after my last little epic, you know, where I put the wrong thing in the wrong hole and...
Yeah.
Do you remember?
Oh, yes, I do.
Yes, she said...
And did she say not too good?
No, she said, I've got to leave the filth up to you.
Mark's mum said that.
So I...
Hello, Mrs. Holden.
Good. So I was very clean. I didn't say anything as rude as bum.
20 pounds on his knees. That's all right.
It's an unusual place, isn't it?
I know. Well, you know, there are portions of our body on different people's bodies. Like, I lost weight recently. I lost 2 pounds off each eye. No, Lee.
Well, everybody puts it on in the bum, don't they? So I said it at last. No, put it on the earlobes.
Earlobes.
That's unusual. Oh, yeah.
Those big lobes hanging down. Tommy?
Should know, you know, because Murphy was very fat all the time, you know, until she went on the diet.
Yeah.
She lost 4 stone.
Did she?
Yep.
That's amazing.
And I was like sleeping with Roy Higgins.
The jockey.
Yeah. Did you ever hug a bag of antlers? Unfortunately, no, I didn't say that either. I said on his nose.
Nose is a nice answer. Abigail, do we have a behind from you?
No, we don't. On his head.
20 pounds on his head.
Great. I didn't say the head of what, I just said his head.
I said his nose.
On his nose, Barry. Barry, I love having Barry on the show because he enjoys it and he laughs a lot.
I thought he might put it on his big toe.
Oh, that would be so heavy. We'll be back with round two of Blankety Blanks. Come back and have some more fun with us. Got to sell this stuff. Susan, A or B, you're the challenger. You have a choice.
I'll try B this time.
B, and everybody plays. Kojak said, who gets a rating of 8 on the O10 network, on a good night, Kojak said, yesterday I was attacked by Indians, but when they saw that I had no hair on my head, they scalped the hair from my blank. I can't do a Kojak impersonation, so I'm doing it as me. Kojak said, yesterday I was attacked by Indians, but when they saw that I had no hair on my head, they scalped the hair from my blank! Stuart has written a very, very nice answer.
Thank you.
That's all right, Ollie.
Good.
Certainly.
Having a little wipe. They supplied me with a little chamois.
He's coming here next month.
Chamois Davis Jr. No, but it's funny, it really is a chamois. After I do this, I feel I want to run out and have a cut and polish too. Kojak said, yesterday I was attacked by Indians, but when they saw that I had no hair on my head, they scalped the hair from my blank.
Armpits?
Armpits. Oh, hurt. Oh, a stinging answer. Armpits, and I think we've got a match for Mark.
What? No.
Nostrils. Oh, that's a nasty answer. Oh, and it wouldn't... No. Oh, no, that would not be funny.
Having a bad day. His armpits, his nostrils, no, his chest.
His chest? Gulped his chest. Tommy.
My uncle used to have a long hair growing out of his nose.
Did he?
Yes. And he'd get drunk, and every time he'd sneeze, it'd crack like a whip.
Really?
And at parties, he'd get drunk, and you'd hold a piece of paper out, and he'd sneeze and cut it in half.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Terrific act.
And he got an attack of hay fever and flogged himself to death. Funniest thing happened to Kojak in a bowling alley the other night.
What happened?
We're just not on the wavelength.
Oh, I know. They put
bent over, and before he knew it, he was a strike.
I'm sorry, Tommy. It's just that the way Dave does it, I'm used to doing it that way.
I know.
I'm sorry. Kojak said, yesterday I was attacked by Indians, but when they saw that I had no hair on my head, they scalped the hair from my... Not quite a pit, is it? No. No, all right.
No.
Abigail, can we find some armpits here?
No, nothing personal.
Well, you've got everything else.
Sergeant.
That's funny. That's funny. Scalp the hair from my sergeant. Stuart.
All those odd places make you smart, wouldn't it?
Well, armpits, the nostrils. Yes. Where else would there be hair? In the lower abdomen. Oh, it stings. Although in national service when I... Yeah, that's a different... I can't do that.
Very short, you had nothing to hold on to down there, would you?
That's true. Chest. No, yes. We're not doing terribly well for Susan. And we continue. Everybody still plays. Tony the moustache twirler said to Peter the phantom puller, that girl at the party must have been a riding instructor. Disgusting. Tony the moustache twirler, that's our producer, Tony Connolly, said to Peter the phantom puller, that's Peter Rees-Jones, that girl at the party must have been a riding instructor. All night she kept saying, blank up! Don't forget our contestants and challengers mightn't know Tony's expression.
Yes.
The point of the game is to help our challenger and our champion, not to help us. Tony the moustache twirler said to Peter the phantom puller, that girl at the party must have been a riding instructor. All night she kept saying, blank up. And Lawrence, you're in the situation where you only need one to win, so we've only got to have one match. Tony the moustache twirler said to Peter the phantom puller, that girl at the party must have been a riding instructor. All night long she kept saying, blank up.
So she say mount up.
Mount up. Now I think I've done the wrong thing.
Well, I'd say that Lawrence has been listening in the corridors.
Because Tony does say that when he wants us to get ready for the show. He says, mount up! And it's just as gentle and as charming as that.
And that's what I said.
Mount up. Yeah. Would everyone hold their cards up? What? Mount up, get up. Paul, get up, mount up. Come up, Lawrence, you're our remaining champion. You've already got $1,000. Susan, I hate to do this to you. We're going to have to say goodbye, and you haven't won a cent.
But
the Toshiba people have something for you, which is worth hundreds of dollars. Thank you for playing Blankety Blanks. Good night. All say good night to Susan. Don't forget to write. $1,000. You're a successful Kentucky Fried Chicken gentleman. How much did you take last week?
I'm not allowed to say that.
Will you tell me after? Because I've been offered a franchise. About how much it is.
Okay.
We'll be back after the chat privately. But first, we got to sell this stuff. Don't go away. Come back and play Blankety Blanks with us tomorrow night.
Certainly.
Good night. Good night. You've been a lovely panel. You really have. You've been superb. Thank you, Mark. Good night, Abigail. Good. No, Stuart. We can't keep on doing that. Good night, Noel. Oh, Nolene. All right.
God, striking.
Yeah, I know, but it's because I walk up the stairs and everything.
Oh, I know, but it's worth it.
Okay. You want a big one?
Oh, a real one.
Yeah.
Oh, it was lovely. I've nearly thought.
Good night, Tom. Night, everyone. Oh, dear.
All prices are moved by Grace Brothers Removals, the professionals. Interstate artists Fly Unset and Brian Davis, we try harder. Whilst in Sydney, Graham Kennedy chooses to stay at the Boulevard Hotel, 90 William Street, King's Cross. We'll be right back. is a Reg Crumley production, produced in colour at the studios of Channel 10 Sydney in association with the O10 Network. Don't wait speaking.